Now I'm going to share my screen. I think my screen is visible. Now we are going to understand what is the flow of a React application. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to execute it like npm start. Okay, now we can see. Okay, so Angular, React has executed a 3000 port number. So here, this application is a public. Open this public. Here you can see this. There is an index.html. That's the executable. That is, I think you know that mostly website have a main file name is index.html. Same as index.html is also a first file that will execute on web browser. So you can click on index.html. We cannot disturb this file. Okay, here you can see this is a HTML. There are links, title. This is a React app. This is a title. Here no script. If your browser is not supporting JavaScript, then it will, this message will appear. And here div id is equal to root. Okay, and here body. So here you can see this in the body only one there is a div, okay, and it's showing this screen. Okay, so how it is possible? So actually all thing is working on the basis of this ID. So where is this ID? So if you want to understand what is the flow of this, okay, so for this purpose, this is a public, we will not disturb this folder. The main folder is src, okay, and there are app css, app.js file for testing file. This is a index.css file. This is index.js file. Okay, this is logo file. Okay, so we are going to delete the each and everything, and we are going to create application as per our requirement and try to understand what is the flow of a React application. Okay, so you can see this is src here multiple files, and I'm going to delete this like here app.cs. Currently we have not need of these files. Okay. So this is SRC folder. Currently it is blank. So now we are going to show this. What is the current view on the screen, on the browser? So you can see here. Okay, all files has deleted. You can see here. Now I'm going to refresh it, and you can see this. If index.html has executed, but here module not found error cannot resolve my data react first app SRC index.js means. It have need of index.js file that will that location of the index.jsp should be src. Okay, so we are going to create a index.jsp file. So now here this is a file and folder, here click here and index.js file. Okay, so what is the content of this index.js file? For this purpose we are going to import from React DOM. Okay, what is React DOM? So you can see here in this is a module of React. So here you can see this React.js, React.do, these are the modules. Okay, with the help of this, we will create the React application. So here, we are going to use React.do. Okay, and here must be declare a variable. Suppose we will use React.do to the this React.do to the React. Here you can specify any name. Okay. After that here we have need of a method name is render. Okay, and this render method is a part of React.do. So here I have declared React.do dot render. Okay, this is a function, and this function, this method have two parameter. Okay, so here you can declare this like h1, you can specify anything like hello, hello everyone. Okay, and we want to show this hello everyone at the place of here. You can see this is HTML, this is a root ID. I want to show that value on the root ID. So for this purpose I will declare here document dot get element by ID, and here we can specify the ID. Our ID name is root. Okay, save this file. And now we want to open browser. So you can see here. Okay, refresh it and you can see this hello everyone. Okay, the all content of your page currently it removed. Okay, so here you can see this. So here we are trying to show this index.html have a ID, that is a root. So we can show each and everything because the ID, root ID, we will show the whole page, whole application on this ID. That is the main thing. Okay, because this is a one page, a single page application. So only index.html will load on the browser, and the other content will load in index.html. So that is a place where we will show the each and every. That is a place, that is ID. We will use this ID and show all component, all things we will show on this ID. I think you know JavaScript. So here we use, you can see this index.html. So currently I am showing here, I am trying to display, execute this heading at the root ID. Okay, now suppose we want to show another line also. So for this purpose I am going to here h2 welcome to Arish. Okay, but you can see here it's showing error. Actually we can show only the one line, one parameter we can show on the browser. We can set only the, from here we can only show the one content on this, at this ID. Okay, so for this purpose if you want to show the whole content, for this purpose React provide us a React fragment, that is called React fragment. Okay, so you can wrapping as the all content in this wrap fragment. Okay, so within this wrap fragment we can add multiple lines. This is app, this is a React fragment. Within this wrap React fragment we can add multiple lines, like suppose here hello everyone and welcome to Arish. Save this file and again you can show here welcome to Arish. Okay, so within this React fragment we can add multiple lines. Okay, like suppose here I declare any other line. Anything you can type here. Okay, so you can add any number of lines within the React fragment. Okay, so you can say here we can add multiple lines, one page only. So at the place of this we can save this content in a component. It's also work on the basis of component. It is same as Angular. Okay, but only the difference between that, if we will create a component in Angular, so that provide us four files, one HTML, one CSS, two TS file. But here it is very different. So here we have need to create a component. So basically we know that the app component is the main component in Angular, same as you can create app component in React. So for this purpose I am going to create a new file, name is app.js. This is a component. Okay, and we can declare the all things that already declared, I have declared in the as the first argument, as the first parameter in a render method. we can transfer these values in the app component, and we can call this app component in render method as a first argument, so as a first parameter. Okay, so for this purpose here, this is a first component. So here it's very simple, only create a file .js that is a component in React. Okay, here if you want to create a component in React, for this purpose we can use function, we can create a function, or we can create a class both, but mostly we work on functions. Okay, so function space, you can specify the function name, so the function name is same as your file name, your component name, like app.js. So here we will create a function. Okay, after that we can here, we can send here like h1 and have a React. Okay, if we want to use this, I suppose we want to make it as a public, we can use this app anywhere in application. So for this purpose we will export it and specify this name. Okay, so if you export this as a default, so we can use this app anywhere in our application. We can use any module. Actually we are creating this as a module. Okay, so if we want to use this module anywhere in application, so for this purpose we can must be export this module. Okay, so suppose we want to use this module, this component in index.js, so at the place of these values we can remove this. Okay, and as a first argument, as a first parameter, we can call this component. Okay, but this component must be import here, so for this purpose here we use import app from app.js. We have not need to specify extension. Okay, now you can see this hello React. Currently as a first argument, as a first parameter, we are calling this app. Okay, so here index.js, so as a first argument I am using app, and we want to show the content of app component at the place of root id. Okay, and render is a method, this have two parameter. Okay, first we will pass that values, and here as a second part we declare the location, place where we want to show the content of this. Okay, understood? It's okay, you can see this. Okay, now you can here, you can specify, suppose you want to use multiple lines. Okay, so for this purpose you can use React fragment, and within this fragment you can add as you like. come to Arish Info Tech. Okay, you can see this. You can add anything you want to add here. Paragraph. As you need, you can declare here each and everything, like here. As you need, you can declare it. Okay. But here, there is only one component. But we can divide, Angular, we can divide a component in multiple components. Okay. So here, we can create a list of components. Before this, we want to use CSS. Okay. After that, we will create the multiple components. Okay, no problem. First of all, I'm going to create component. Okay, so here we can create a folder. Okay, the name of the folder, that name is components. And within this component, we will create the different components like header. header.js. Okay. footer.js. So you can see here creation of component is very easy. These are the components: footer, header, and suppose I'm going to create a home. home.js. Okay. After that, suppose header, we can create here like function header, and here we use export default header. Okay. Same as here. Control Z. You can use here. Okay. And this is a home. So here we declare as a home. As a home. Okay. Second thing, as a footer. We can copy here. Footer. And here we can declare here the footer. Okay, suppose we want to show here there is a header. So here we use return. Here we can declare. Header section. Currently I'm using only single line, so we have not need of a React fragment, but I use it. We can use multiple lines, no problem. Save this file. Okay. You can remove it, no problem, but in future, if suppose you want to use multiple lines, so we will use it. And same thing I'm going to copy in other component. Okay, this is a footer section. Okay, and this is a home section. So here page, and we want to call this page in app. Okay, at the place of this. Okay, like this we are calling this. Okay, at the place of this, hello React and welcome to Arish. I'm going to remove this, and at the place of this I'm going to declare the all component. Okay, so here you can see this, like here I declare the component is name is header, after that home, after that footer. Okay, but we have need to import this all component. For this purpose, import header from component and name is header. Okay, semicolon. Same thing, we can copy it. And here we use home. Footer. Save this file, and now I'm going to open this. You can see the header section, home base, and footer section. Okay, understood? So here, first of all, this file will execute. Okay, and it will call id root. Okay, after that, here I have declared app.js, sorry, index.js, and here we are using, you can specify any name here, it's not mandatory you declare React app, but React DOM, this is mandatory. Okay, and it provides us a method name is render, and render have two parameter, and in first parameter we will pass that thing which we want to show on the web browser, and the second part we will declare that id where we want to show that content. Okay, so here I have declared a app component. Okay, so for app component here I declare app.js. in app.js we are calling multiple component. Okay, so for this purpose I declare a new, create a new folder, name is component, and this component have three component, footer, header and home. So we create it and call it. Understood? Any doubt, any queries? Hello. It's okay. Any doubt, any queries? So please do this. Okay. After that, we will try to add CSS. How to use CSS in React. So first of all, do this. After that, we will try to add CSS file in this component. Okay.